everybody. Glad to see y'all here tonight. I know you guys are here to see all our kids, and they are full of energy, so I know it's going to be a good night. Our preschool choir is going to sing here in just a minute, and then the older kids are going to sing after that and do their musical. It's been a good day. I think that the musical, heard a lot of good things about the musical this morning. I want to invite everybody to stick around after the service, as we will be over in the gym. Everybody is welcome. Everybody's invited to come over there for our church Christmas party. We have finger foods and desserts and coffee and that type of stuff over there. And also, we've done this the last several years. The deacons have done a bag for everybody with some fruit, some gum, candy bars, breath mint, peppermint, that type of stuff in there. So we have one of those. Should have one of those for everybody tonight. So we want to invite everybody to stick around after the service and join us over there in the gym. But I'm not going to be too long, because I know you just can't do that with a whole bunch of kids sitting here. So let's get started. We're going to have a word of prayer, and Alicia's going to come lead us in a song. So will you pray with me? Lord, I thank you so much for allowing us to be here tonight. I'm thankful that we could gather this morning and celebrate the birth of Jesus, and that we can come back here tonight and do the same thing. So I pray for our kids. Lord, I pray that when they get up on the stage, they would not be nervous. I pray that when they get up, they would sing for you. And Lord, I pray that we would all be able to worship you tonight, to celebrate and to pause from the busy schedule at this time of year. And Lord, I pray that it'll be a good time of us celebrating as a church family, with maybe with our individual families. But I pray that we all have a great time tonight. I pray for anyone sitting out here that doesn't know you as Lord and Savior, that maybe before we leave this place tonight, they would come to put their faith and their trust in you. So we thank you for all you do for us. Lord, I pray that this would be a great night. And I ask this prayer in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. We wanted to start the night off with giving everybody a chance to sing one of our favorite classic Christmas carols. So sing with me, Angels We Have Heard on High.
Thank you.
All right, thank you all of our preschoolers, and thank you to everybody that works with it. We really appreciate it. I'm going to turn it over to Miss Nancy and our kids choir here, as they're going to present for us their Christmas music.
So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Bethlehem, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child.
Oh, little town. Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord.
Suddenly a great company of heavenly hosts appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, Glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace to men on whom his favor rests.
Lord, the Lord is come.
wise men from the east came to Jerusalem. They asked, "Where is the one who has been born the King of the Jews? We saw his star in the east and have come to worship him."
Job, and they've got another song they're going to do in a minute, a real fun upbeat song to take us out with tonight. But before we get to that, we just want to pause for a minute and talk a little bit about what they have just been singing about. I love Luke chapter 2. It gives us they've quoted it. That's what all those verses have come from, where we get the narrative of the birth of Jesus. And when the shepherds, the Bible says, were terrified out in the field, but the angels came and said, "Fear not, don't be afraid, we're bringing you good news." And that's what this is all about. The story of Christmas is good news. And the angels would go on and say that we are coming to bring peace on earth. And think about what that means for just a minute before we move on tonight, about having peace. That was what they had been looking for all those years. And there may be some people in this room tonight that are in search of peace. That's what Jesus comes to offer us. He doesn't just come to offer us heaven, which is great. He doesn't just come to offer us the ability to pray, which is great. He doesn't just offer us the ability to fellowship with other believers and bear each other's burdens and have people intercede for us. All those things are great. But Jesus comes to offer peace between mankind and God. Adam and Eve didn't need that at first. They had a perfect relationship with God, but after sin entered the world, that relationship was damaged, and they found themselves in need of peace. And every person who's ever lived since that day is in that same boat, looking for peace. But the only way to find it is when God came down to us, when he put on human flesh and did what Jesus did. And we celebrate Christmas because God came to earth. I said that this morning. I know a lot of y'all heard me say it this morning. But God didn't ask us to become good enough to go up to where he is. He said, "That's impossible, so I'll come down to where they are." And he did something that we could never do for ourselves. He lived a sinless life. He gave up his life to die on the cross for us so that our sins can be forgiven. That problem between us and God. The reason we are not at peace with God, and this is a strong word that you might not hear in a lot of churches, but the Bible says we are enemies of God because of our sin. And because we're enemies of God, we will never be at peace with him. But Jesus comes to remove that which makes us his enemy, that sin problem. We don't become sinless. Don't say, "Well, I've still sinned. I must not be." That's not what I'm talking about. We'll never be sinless. But God removes that sin problem. And if he's never removed that from you, then you're not at peace with God tonight. And so you might try to fill that or try to find peace by doing other things. People look for hobbies and relationships and making more money and burying themselves at work and doing a lot of things to try to fill that. Other people look to say, "Well, I went to church or I read my Bible or I gave some money," and they try to find that peace. But none of those things will work, guys. The only way to find that peace is to submit your life to Jesus. Bow your knee before him. And if you call out to him, he will remove that sin. And when he does that, you're no longer enemies. But the Bible says that he will adopt you as his son and his daughter. So instead of being God's enemy, you can be his child. It's a no-brainer for you. Maybe tonight, there's someone in this room, you say, "You know what, I need that. I don't have peace with God. I've been trying to work my way into his good graces, but it just doesn't work." Maybe tonight somebody wants to call out for that peace, that forgiveness. And I promise you, God will do that tonight. So Miss Nancy's going to play a song for us. I'm going to ask if you'd stand up right where you are. We're not going to drag this out all night, I promise. But maybe there's someone here tonight and you say, "I want that peace he's talking about. I want that joy those kids were singing about. I want to know Jesus, not just know about him." And if that's you tonight, then we're giving you the opportunity to simply step out from where you are. Walk down here, and there's someone here that will meet you and pray with you. And we'll show you how you can know for sure that you are at peace with God. If today were your last day on earth, do you want to know that heaven would be your home? And Jesus shows us how we can know that for sure. So Lord, I pray these next few minutes that maybe if your Holy Spirit has laid it on someone's heart to step out and come down here and say, "I need to be saved. I want peace. I want my sins forgiven." And I pray that would happen even now, even without anyone waiting. Lord, I pray that someone would step out to find out what they can do to be saved. I thank you for the gift of Jesus Christ. The very first Christmas gift is when you loved us so much, you sent the best that you possibly had for us. And we thank you for the gift of Jesus. So Lord, I pray right now, if anyone wants prayer, anyone wants peace, let's step out from where they are. I ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. Use this time as Miss Nancy plays. Thank you. maybe see, he told y'all what, drag it out. But maybe tonight, maybe you're like right in the middle of an aisle or something. Maybe say, I really should have stepped out there. Don't leave tonight if you don't know that you have peace, that you are at peace with God. I'm going to be around here for a while. There's plenty of others. So if you want prayer, you have any other questions, come find us before you go. We're going to turn it back over to our kids one more time for their finale. So come stick around. It's not a school night, amen, parents. So you can go, amen, kids. So you can go over there after service. Stick around as long as you like. And there's a fruit bag for everybody, gift for everybody. So I'm gonna ask if you would rise to your feet, and we will dismiss in prayer tonight. All right, let's pray. Lord, I thank you so much once again for allowing us to be here. I'm thankful that this morning and again tonight we're able to celebrate the birth of Jesus, which as Christians is really something that is a part of who we are 365 days a year. And what an incredible gift that was given to us. Lord, I pray that we have a good time tonight as we continue to fellowship together. I pray as we leave that you keep everyone safe as we head back our separate ways tonight. And Lord, I pray for everyone, whatever their plans may be for Monday and Tuesday. Lord, I pray that everyone in this room has a very Merry Christmas and that we keep you at the center of all of it. Thank you for all you do for us. We pray for a great night, and we ask this prayer in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you. Have a good night.